Hello everyone, welcome to Dr. Bettersize's lab. Have you ever seen an avalanche close up? Why is it that all appears fine, then suddenly the snow begins to fall? This movement is associated with how the snow piles up on the mountain. Normally, the snow piles up relatively well. However, if the snowmelt turns into ice and the slope angle gets too steep, then fresh snow will easily start to slide down the slope. This critical slope angle is called the angle of repose. So, what is angle of repose? Well, due to its wide applications and different material properties, such as moisture content, morphology, particle size distribution, etc., it is challenging to find a one-size-fits-all solution to define what the angle of repose is. Typically speaking, the angle of repose is the steepest angle relative to the horizontal plane, which a material can be piled without slumping or the surface material sliding. Why angle of repose is so important? The angle of repose is important because it allows us to quickly understand the flowability of granular materials in many industries. In pharmaceuticals, the angle of repose can be used to indicate the flowability of granular powders to ensure uniform composition of powder mixtures in the drug production. In food and beverage, the angle of repose can be used to design the silo and then determine its dimensions, as well as to reduce materials waste. In geotechnical engineering, it can be used in the study of slope stability analysis. The angle of repose can also be applied in many other sectors as well. How do we measure the angle of repose? There are three common methods to measure the angle of repose: fixed funnel, tilting box, and revolving cylinder. Similar to its definition, these methods need to be selected based on specific material and application. In general, the fixed funnel method could meet your major application needs. In the fixed funnel method, the granular material is poured from a fixed funnel at a certain height onto a flat base. Then stop pouring the material when the heap reaches a predetermined width. A professional angle of repose tester will help you obtain an accurate and operator-independent result. Let us use the fixed funnel method to conduct a demonstration. From this experiment, we can see that angle of repose has an inverse relationship with the flowability of its granular material. Normally, the lower the angle of repose is, the better the powder flowability is. What is the angle of difference and what does it mean? After measuring the angle of repose, apply an external force to the powder pile to collapse it. The angle between the slope of the collapsed pile and the horizontal plane is defined as angle of fall. The angle of difference is calculated by subtracting the angle of fall from the angle of repose. A larger angle of difference suggests better floodability. Want to know about what floodability is? Stay tuned and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already. See you next time.